Hello and welcome! In this video we are going to take a look at the new critical temperature calculation in Consteel 14. But first, let's review some background. First of all, what does the critical temperature mean? It's easy to understand this through a simple example. So let's say we have this steel column with a normal force that has an around 50% utilization at room temperature. If we start to gradually increase the temperature of the column, the material properties would gradually decrease, and with that the resistances would also decrease. Therefore, the utilization would increase. At a certain point, the utilization would reach 100%, and the temperature at which it does is called the critical temperature. In other words, the critical temperature is the maximum allowable material temperature at which a certain structural member can still carry its mechanical load. If we look at the structural design workflow in a fire situation, normally we can calculate the internal forces and compare it to the resistances of the structural member. For this method, we need to calculate the resistance at a certain elevated temperature. If there is any fire protection on the member, we need to know its heat insulation capability to get this elevated temperature in a certain fire situation. In case of so-called passive protections like gypsum boards or sprayed cement, we know this insulation value, so we can use this assessment method. However, there is a special fire protection type where we cannot know the heat insulation capability and therefore we cannot calculate the elevated temperature. This fire protection is the intumescent paint coating. In case of this protection, a special paint is applied to the member which will expand and develop a foamy structure to increase its heat insulation in reaction to the elevated temperature in the fire situation. In this case, the heat insulation is changing in time as the fire develops, so we can't calculate the elevated temperature in the member and we can't calculate the resistance. Therefore, we cannot use the usual strength domain method. However, we can use an alternative way to perform the structural design for this protection type. That's where the critical temperature comes into play, because in order to calculate it, we don't need to know the heat insulation capability of the fire protection. With the help of the critical temperature, we can determine the necessary paint thickness, which would be our final goal for this kind of fire protection. In case of intumescent paints, laboratory tests are carried out to determine the necessary paint thickness for a range of possible cross-section types and critical temperatures. The results of these tests are compiled into tables that the manufacturer provides for their specific paint product. To use one of these tables, we need to know the section type, the fire exposure, the fire resistance time, the section factor, and the critical temperature. With these inputs, we can finally determine the required paint thickness and ensure that our structure is able to carry its loads until the required fire resistance time. Our goal with Consteel is to provide all the necessary data for this design. So now, let's see how all this works in Consteel. We are going to use the model of this warehouse building for this example. First of all, we need to define the fire load. As you can see, there are a couple load groups already defined. Let's define a new load group for the fire loads and the new load case within that. At this point, it is important to make sure that we are using the room temperature analysis option, because the critical temperature calculation works only with this option active. Let's quickly go through the load cases and check the predefined loads, then select the fire load case. To define the fire effect, we will first need to define the fire protection types that we will need. First, let's define an intumescent paint protection for open sections with fire exposure on three sides. Then let's define another one for an unspecified section type exposed to fire on all sides. we are going to use two different fire resistance times for this model. The mezzanine floor has a 45-minute requirement and the beams are exposed to fire on only three sides, so that's what we set first. The columns are exposed to fire on all sides, so for those we are going to use the other protection type. The rest of the structure has a 30-minute requirement. After application, we can check the fire loads and protection types. Now let's generate load combinations for the design. We are going to need to select the load combinations for accidental design situations. As we can see, the fire load case is included in every load combination that we generated. With that, we are done with the load definition. Let's switch to the analysis tab. In the analysis settings, we will need first and second order analysis, buckling analysis, and also buckling sensitivity assessment. The displacement results look realistic, and we have results for all four combinations. The critical temperature calculation is going to be carried out under the Global Checks tab. First, we are going to calculate the critical temperature based on only the strength of the cross sections. The checkbox for the critical temperature has to be checked here. The critical temperature results can be viewed if we click the Design Parameters button and select Theta CR from the drop-down menu. Now we can see the critical temperature results for all of the members. If we switch to the rafters portion, we will have the lowest critical temperature on the top of the results table for this portion only. Let's give it a marker and check it out in the section module. As we can see, the main result is the critical temperature. We can also see that the dominant calculation method was the conservative interaction resistance in this case. We calculated the material temperature where this method gives 100% utilization, which by definition is the critical temperature. That's why those two values are equal. This section is also a class 4 cross-section, which we can check in the section properties. Alright, now let's calculate the critical temperature based on not only the cross-section strength, but also considering stability phenomena with the help of the results of the buckling analysis. The critical temperatures are generally lower in this case, as expected. The lowest critical temperature in the rafters is 545 degrees Celsius instead of the 657 degrees Celsius, considering only the cross-section strength. If we open up the section module now, we can see that the dominant calculation method is changed to the global stability resistance. The conservative interaction resistance gives only 47.7% utilization at this lower temperature. Detailed results for checks based on pure resistances at the critical temperature are also available here. Now let's check the lowest critical temperature for the columns. And lastly, let's check the results for the mezzanine floor. Here the lowest critical temperature comes from a beam. The floor beams are assumed to be braced by the floor slab against buckling, so they are excluded from the stability model portion, therefore no stability calculation is carried out for them. That's why the dominant calculation method is the conservative interaction resistance. Now that we checked the important results, let's start to work on the documentation. We will create a report for intumescent paint design. In the documentation, the relevant information is compiled into tables. The tables contain the following data: section type, section name, fire protection, member ID, element ID, member surface area to be painted, section factor, and the critical temperature. There are separate tables for every different fire resistance time and also for prismatic and variable cross-section beams. The first one is for 30 minutes and prismatic beams. The second one is for 30 minutes and variable cross-section beams. And the last table is for 45 minutes and prismatic beams. Let's create a snapshot of the model portion that has the 45-minute fire resistance requirement with the member ID numbers in order to make the report easier to follow. Getting back into the documentation editor, the figure can be inserted. This way, we can make all the necessary information available only from the report. For example, let's check the top row of the design results table, which is about the member B200 that has a critical temperature of 637.7 degrees Celsius. In the report, we can identify this member in the figure and we can also find it in the table below. This concludes our demonstration of the critical temperature calculation in Consteel 14. We hope you found this video useful. If you did, please consider liking and subscribing. Also visit consteelsoftware.com and download the trial version of Consteel for free if you are interested. Thank you for your attention. Bye!